It is looking righteous out here. It's marvelous. I put some corn in here about a week ago, and it's already sprouting and looking righteous. You know, let me show you. Let me flip this boy around. Oh.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
But with this bed, I've got literally from here on, so I've got that much space still to put stuff. I don't know what to put yet, and with this side is gonna be the same. I got that much space. It's looking like I'm gonna have to put some kale over there or some broccoli. That'd be fly. Some broccoli, some kale, some squash. Who knows? I gotta show y'all my rooster, man, cause I know some of y'all are wondering. Ooh, got some birds flying over. Got some birds flying. But look, there goes my house. That's not my house. They're not my house. That ain't my house. I'm in the middle of a neighborhood, and I've got a rooster, and we haven't got any complaints yet.
What a truly tantalizing tidbit of Tyler Tattletale technology.
Gotta throw him that chicken crack. Gotta throw him that chicken crack. Some corn for him. Feeling festive. I mean, it happens. You dig what I'm saying? Sometimes you just get that chicken that you think is gonna be a girl, and it ends up crowing 8 weeks later, and you're like, we gotta get rid of it, but someone ain't trying to get rid of it. But you see him? Dude, he's got no problem in the world. Roscoe, tell me, you got any complaints, bro? You don't like the collar? Do you like the collar? Yeah, you're good. You're solid. A lot of people are always scared, like, it's gonna hurt my rooster. Roscoe, are you in pain, bro? Look at him. He might jump on me now. He looks hungry. Hey, Roscoe. One thing I can note, though, when using these collars, sometimes people will put them on too tight, and it could restrict the airway up top. If your rooster's comb is getting dull, take the collar off and maybe adjust it. You know, make it a little bit more loose. It is just something you got to make sure to check on. He hasn't ever had a problem, and he's a big rooster, you know. But Roscoe, it's time, brother. They want to see your collar. They want to see your collar, bro. Okay. I gotta show him. I gotta show him how to do it.
Oh, Roscoe.
Got him. He's actually one of my top boys, one of my top dogs. Dude, it is hot out here. Even though some of y'all are probably wearing sweaters already. Us in Arizona, we're still on this, we're still patting, we're still fanning. Look at him, he's chilling. And this is his little collar. It's two pieces of Velcro, just Velcroed to each other. Some people say you gotta get double-sided Velcro. I don't see that as a, I don't see that necessary. Let me get you set up, boy. He's gonna crow right when this gets off, watch. Ooh. Two pieces of Velcro just stuck on top of each other like that. Don't do it. I gotta get this thing on him. Cause yeah, like I said, my neighbors, they don't play. You know, Arizona's got them old people, so. Hey, which I love. I love me some, a little bit of cougar action. He actually ain't being loud right now. I might even be able to show you. So, gets a little bit hectic on the inside, but yeah, two pieces of Velcro, just Velcro to each other. Show you, pop, pop, that's all it is. You don't need no tape, you don't need no cloth. And then you find the hackle feathers where the feathers kind of meet the plumage. You find that and you go under it. So you get your hand, kind of wrap it around his neck, wrap it around his neck. But don't be choking him. Just like right above the skin. You ain't gotta go deep, cause yeah, right above the skin. He's chilling. And then I'll let it go and he's still cooling. His feathers are a little bit worn down from the collar, which I mean, it's not a problem. It doesn't hurt him. It's just less feathers. Hold up, Roscoe, it's a little hard. And then you just place it on. Naturally, when you put them on the ground, they're not gonna like the collar at first, for like the first like probably like 20-30 minutes. You're not gonna see a lot of movement from them. They're just gonna be chilling, like on the ground, maybe with their head tilted low, backing up. Yeah, that's just them trying to get the collar off. But after 20-30 minutes, they're used to it and they're solid. Another thing that I wanted to point out real quick, when it first gets put on, you can make sure it's not too tight by just slide your pinky in there. Make sure your pinky fits in between the collar and the rooster's skin. No, my pinky's going in there. My pinky fits. I'm able to put my little finger in there. But yeah, then he's good. He's like, oh, what? It's a fight. It's a fight. Yeah, they're gonna back up a little bit, but he's just getting used to it. He ain't trying. See? I was like, bruh. There we go. There we go. You good, Roscoe? You good, bro. Hey, if it means you ain't getting eaten, brother, be happy. And since I've got the rooster and I've got the hens, I'm able to incubate my own eggs. So we get the fertile eggs. Look at them chasing me. So, hit my bonker, jeez. But let me see how many eggs we've got today. It looks like we've got 6 eggs. Oh, we could have had more. Whenever you get eggs with like yellow stuff on, like that is egg yolk. You know, so one of your chickens was probably, you probably got an egg eater in the flock. And there's a piece of shell on this one. I mean, it's not a big deal to me. I like their eggs too. I can understand how they like them. Hey, how do you like my lights? How do you like my lights in the coop? I know it's not Christmas, but like I said, things are starting to get festive around here, even though it's hot. I need to get these eggs right quick. There we go, 6 eggs. I think I'm gonna put these to the side. I'm not gonna hatch them yet, but I will. I'm excited to hatch this little mini egg. I'm actually just gonna say frick it and just put them in today. Here we go. This is her. She's on day like, I wanna say today's day for these eggs in here. I have 7 in there right now. I wanna say it's day,
down.
Dang, it's probably like day 8. Sometimes I lose track. But I'm gonna throw these things in there right now and take a gander at this little mini egg. Look at that thing. Hey, I'm actually kind of excited for this. Might be a little troll chicken. Let me get these things in here really quick and I'll show you after. Here's the egg. The pointy side is up. The kind of round side is pointing to the down. So what you want to do when you put it in the incubator, put it face down. That ensures that the chickens, they're able to breathe and everything. Honestly, I ain't gonna go too in depth. I don't know why, but I just know that's what you do. Boom. And in 21 days, they'll be here. Be prepared. You know, I'm excited to see what they got. The barred rocks, all of them end up having like the bar gene. Even though all of them have the barred gene with the barred rocks, it's all still so cool. You just get different variations from every type of chicken that you put it to, but it's gonna be fly. It can happen, it can work. You guys can make it work in the city. You saw my boy Roscoe, he don't even talk that much. He doesn't really talk. He's thinking, minds his own business and does his thing, goes on with his day. Dude, if someone freaking hassles you on it, tell him. Tell him Big Dad wants to talk to him. Buddy, you seen, I just put the collar on him. He's He ain't struggling, he ain't jumping, he ain't. My boy is cooling.
You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me.